In this video lecture, we will talk about the monosaccharides. This lecture is a part of the lecture, YouTube lectures from my YouTube channel, Dr. Biochem Lectures. My name is Alam Zeb. I am a professor at the Department of Biochemistry, University of Malacca. I did PhD from the Institute of Biochemistry, Graz, University of Technology, Graz, Austria. Content of this videos which we will discuss is introduction about monosaccharides, classification of monosaccharides, and the structure of monosaccharides. Introduction. As we know that monosaccharides are the first class of the carbohydrate. Mono means one and saccharide means sugar. Monosaccharide cannot be hydrolyzed further into simple sugars. General formula is CnH2nOn. They play important role in metabolism and energy production. Usually they are colorless, water soluble, and crystalline solid. The two important example is that of the glucose. You can see here it is a white crystalline powder, and glucose is a low sugar, while fructose is also a monosaccharide, and you can see here is the white crystals. Now we will talk about the classification of monosaccharides. The first classification, which is based on the functional group, which are specific type of groups present in each molecules. The first class is aldose with aldehyde functional group. The second class of the monosaccharide is ketose with a ketone functional group. So we have two functional groups in monosaccharides. You can see here this one is aldose, a glucose, and which is CHO is the aldehyde, and here you can see fructose with the carboxylic acid group. Now we will see some examples of the aldose sugars. Aldose sugars are polyhydroxyaldehyde and their derivatives. The numbering usually starts from aldehyde groups, which is considered as a group number one. You can see here 3 carbon, 4 carbon, 5 carbon, and 6 carbon aldose sugars. These are the different examples. Now the ketose sugars, the second class of monosaccharide is a ketose sugars. These are called polyhydroxy ketones. In this case, the numbering starts from the carbonyl carbon, which is usually carbon number 2, and here you can see the examples with the 3 carbon, 4 carbon, 5 carbon, and 6 carbon sugars, ketoses. The second classification of the monosaccharide is based on the numbers of carbon atoms. This is the second classification. In this case, the first class is trioses, which have 3 carbon atoms. The second class is tetroses, which have 4 carbon atoms. The third class of the monosaccharide is pentoses, having 5 carbon atoms, and hexoses having 6 carbon atoms, while heptoses, which is quite rare, they have 7 carbon atoms. Here you can see the examples of the 3 carbon, 4 carbon, 5 and 6 carbon atoms. And here you can see the example of the ketoses and the 3, 4, 5 and 6 carbon atoms. Now the structure of monosaccharides. The structure of monosaccharide is usually explained in open structure and the ring structure. The open chain structure is very easy to write. The numbering started from the carbonyl carbon. It is linear unbranched, the carbon skeleton with one carbon functional group and hydroxyl group on each of the remaining carbons. These are the examples. Now the second type of structure is the ring structure. The structure, ring structure, is similar to pyrene and purine. You can see here the 5-member ring, furan and pyrene is a 6-member ring. They are formed by the carbonyl group and hydroxyl group. The resultant compound is either hemiketaol or hemicetal. The hemi means half. The name ends, the name of the sugars ends usually with OSE. Now, Howard determined the pyranose structure of the glucose in 1915. The enumeric carbon can be found by methylation of the hydroxyl group, then hydrolysis by this particular reaction. Now the Howard projection formula. The Howard projection formula is the representation of the ring structure. It is the common way of writing a structure of monosaccharide or the structure formula to represent a cyclic structure of monosaccharide. This structure is usually three-dimensional. You can see here, and the numbering usually starts from the carbonyl carbon atoms. The carbonyl carbon in aldoses is carbon number 1, while in the case of the fructoses, it is carbon number 2.